Hello, welcome to another Becoming a Modern Man. We are playing Blue Black Fairies this time around, taking advantage of the fact that Bitter Blossom was reprinted in Modern Masters 2015. So yeah, you can pick that up at a fairly decent price these days. The list I'm working with is kind of a mishmash of various Blue Black Fairies decks I saw online. Nothing particularly out of the ordinary, I suppose. Got our discard suite and the Thoughtseize Inquisitions, counters in Spellsnare, Banalique, Cryptic, and then we've got our fairies, Mistbind Click, Vendilion Click, trying out Sign of Una as well as a one-off, and then the Spellstutter Sprite. Then Snapcast is in there for value, being able to replay our spells. Also got some removal in the form of Go Throat, Dismember, Murderous Cut, and a Sword of Fire and Ice. Various swords you can see around. I quite like Fire and Ice, but depends kind of on your metagame. Got another sword on the sideboard as well. And the mana base, blue-black lands for the most part. We also get Creeping Tar Pit and Moot Vault, so we've got quite a lot of man lands in there, which is pretty nice. Sideboard, got some counter spells, a bit more discard, a bit more removal. Got some relics, Spellskite, and another sword in there. Quite like sort of Light and Shadow as a way to gain life, because it's quite a lot of life loss in this deck in the form of Bitter Blossom, Thoughtseize, etc. Dismember, so sometimes useful to be able to get that back. But anyway, let's just get into some matchups, shall we? And in this video, I'm going to be looking at a matchup against Red Green Tron. So let's see if we can get this one underway. This is our opener. Always like to see a turn 2 Bitter Blossom. Always very nice. Mana Leak as well. It's a good one to have. And then Mistbind Click. It's a decent late game play as well. Opponent is on the play. Leads off with a relic. It's fine. We're going to lead off with Tar Pit. It's the only land that comes into play tapped. Actually, Drowned Catacombs would come into play tapped at the moment, as if we don't have an island or a swamp. So hopefully we'll draw a basic land at some point to sort that out, or a fetch. Opponent plays another mine and just passes the turn. Lightning start for our opponent. We're just going to route Bitter Blossom here. I could have kept up counter magic, but it doesn't look like he's going to be doing anything too exciting anytime soon. Looks like he stalled a bit. Opponent plays a third mine, which definitely doesn't bode well for him. He has an Oblivion Stone. At least a little bit scary, something we need to be conscious of. So we're just going to hold back here, let Bitter Blossom do its thing. For 1 point of attack damage there, unfortunately. So I'm assuming our opponent, given that he's not really doing a whole lot, is just of expensive cards. Probably Karns and Wormcoils and etc, etc. Which is sort of good and bad. Obviously, as soon as he draws out, or he sort of finds his lands, then we're going to be in a bit of trouble, if that's the case. But we've got a nice array of counter magic here. Draw a sprite as well, which is good. But it goes for scrying. Got a mana leak that. I could have spell stuttered instead, I guess, but at this point spell stutter might be able to counter something a little bit bigger than that. If we can get some more fairies onto the battlefield, might be able to counter one of his big spells. Also spells, I don't really want anything to just die to this Oblivion. Don't want him to get too much value out of it. So I contemplate clicking here. I can't quite remember why I decided against it in the end. And we are going to click here. Yeah, so we're going to click here, tapping down his lands. That means if he finds the fifth, he can't just use the Oblivion Stone. I think the opponent just puts a fake counter on his Oblivion Stone, which is entirely pointless. And we take away the Bitter Blossom this way. When he does crack the Oblivion Stone, maybe it'll be next turn. Then that way we have something that will come back afterwards in the form of Bitter Blossom, and then we can sort of rebuild from there, hopefully. We also have a sword, which combines pretty nicely with Bitter Blossom. But again, I don't really want to just run it out into an Oblivion Stone. He also didn't have the fifth land there, so that certainly plays into our hands. going to get to attack for 7 here, I think. I'll come down to 11. That goes for a Pyroclasm. Again, it doesn't look like I got their 5th land. So I'm just going to drop the Spellstutter Sprite, adds a bit of extra power to the board, and we think we can attack for lethal next turn. If we activate the Treeping Tarpit, then we have lethal. We could hook up a creature with the Soul of Fire and Ice, and that would also work, but this shows gives our opponent a little less information, I suppose, so I figure we might as well do this. Also, it's less of a blowout if he has something sort of answer, and then Oblivion Stones is because then we lose our Soul of Fire and Ice for no reason. But yeah, that wraps that one up. Managed to outrace him. It was a bit unlucky to get a bit stuck there by the looks of things, but maybe kept a slightly greedy hand with lots of big stuff and many ways to find the lands he needed. Let's go on to game 2. So we have Mana Leak, Mistbind Click, Spell Pierce and Duress. Spell Pierce and Duress coming out the sideboard as a potentially good cards against Tron. We can steal most of the stuff in his deck with Duress for the most part, apart from Wurmcoil Engine, I suppose, and Spell Pierce is a good answer to all those non-creature spells that he's running. Opponent leads all the Power Plant into Expedition map, which is fine. I'm going to go for the turn on Duress, see what our opponent's working with. So opponent has a second Power Plant, Forest, the Ancient Stirrings, Chromatic Star, Pyroclasm. So not the most exciting hand for our opponent. He's not got Tron coming anytime particularly soon by the looks of it, even with the Expedition map. So I think I want to take the Stirrings. He can cast that either way, so I mean, if he didn't have the Forest, I might consider taking the Star instead, because then he's forced to try and find another way of making coloured mana. Maybe forces him to use the Expedition map to find Grove of the Burn Willows or something instead. But as he has the green source anyway, I think we're just going to take the Stirrings to try and prevent his ability to find that third Tron piece after he uses the Expedition map. Pyroclasm is a bit of a worry, I suppose, for future, but I mean, we've got counter spells, and as long as we're aware that it's around, I don't think it's the biggest deal. Opponent cracks map, finds such stuff a mine, passes to us. We draw into Bitter Blossom, which is awesome. So 2 games ago we had second turn Bitter Blossom. Certainly very lucky, and one of the best plays we can really have. Opponent plays Chromatic Star, draws a card, another Chromatic Star, passes a turn. We get Bitter Blossom. We Thought Seize, and we see not a whole lot of different stuff, but I think Wurmcoil was the big thing. We might have seen Khan as well, I think, potentially. But he's quite a way off casting either of those spells. But I decided to get rid of the Wurmcoil, given that that's the one that could really hurt us in terms of him gaining quite a lot of life. And just very difficult to deal with our the colours we're in. Wurmcoil Star plays another Power Plant. We crack a fetch. The fairy for the beginning of our turn. Run out an island. Set for 1 here. We can click at the beginning of a turn, but I decide it's probably best to just keep up counter magic at the moment. I feel like clicking will be good if he gets Tron together. Certainly better in that sense. But click is certainly something we could have done to put an extra clock on him. Alternatively, we could have run out the Vendilion click and see what's in his hand. I think that sort of risks allowing him to play something a lot bigger. So decided to just play conservatively here and just see what he does and see if we want to counter it. Opponent tries to play an Oblivion Stone, which I'm just going to Spell Pierce. And decided to Vendilion click at the end of turn. A little unusual play, I suppose, but allows me to see his hand and also puts a better, faster clock on our opponent who isn't really doing a whole lot at the moment, so if we can actually just outspeed him, that seems pretty good for us. So our opponent is all big stuff, pretty much. He's got Khan, Ugin, Worm Coil Engine, and Pyroclasm. Pyroclasm would be an issue, but not with the hand he's got. He's got no way of making red mana. So I think we just leave him with this hand. It's going to take him a while to build up to these big spells. And again, Pyroclasm could be an issue, but only if he draws another Chromatic Star or Chromatic Sphere to actually be able to use it. And then, depending on how he's played, it's still possible that we'll be able to man leak that or find a counter for it. So make another token at the beginning of our turn. Draw a sword, which is fine, but we're not going to tap out for it clearly here, so just going to hit for 5. And then probably thinking about clicking at the beginning of his turn. Yeah. So I'm going to use Mistbind Click here. Which just steals another turn from my opponent, basically. And then our opponent concedes, so yeah, we would hit 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 next turn, putting up and down to 4. And if we'd had, if we found a land on top, we would have probably played and equipped a sword, which would have definitely finished our opponent off. So yeah, that worked out pretty well. Bit of Blossom in full effect, dropping on turn 2 in both games, and play pretty well. Mistbind Click also really nice against Tron, being able to tap down their lands and just force them to not really do much due to the fact they don't really have any instants or anything they can do to respond to Mistbind Click is really nice, and works really well as a way of beating them down and stopping them from doing what they want to do. So yeah, pretty happy with this matchup in the games I've played. Blue-Black Fairy seems to be a fairly good matchup against Red-Green Tron, but you do have to worry about Pyroclasm, etc. But otherwise, it seems like a fairly good matchup.